Welcome to MyProjectBazaar.com. The project title is Efficient Audit Service Outsourcing for Data Integrity in Clouds. Let's see the abstract. In this project, the system addressed the construction of an interactive PDP protocol to prevent the prevalence of brewer and the leakage of verified data. The system provides an efficient and secure cryptographic integrity audit scheme for public auditability. This scheme retains the soundness property and zero knowledge property of proof in system. The system proposes an efficient approach based on the probabilistic queries and periodic version for improving the performance. In existing system, the system used traditional cryptographic techniques for data integrity and availability. These techniques were based on the hash function and signature schemes, but it cannot work on the outsourced data with a local copy of data. In addition, it is not practically a solution for data validation by downloading them due to the expensive transaction, especially for large size files. The disadvantages is the probability of cloud data is subjected to district due to the survival of hardware and software collapse and human mistakes. Data is not in an encrypted format. Group ring key generation not used in the existing purpose. It behaves unfaithfully toward the cloud user. It cannot work on the outsourced data without a local copy of our proposed system. The system proposes an architecture of audit service outsourcing for verifying the integrity of outsourced storage in clouds. This architecture, based on the cryptographic verification protocol, does not need to store trust in a storage service provider. This proposed method is focused on the efficient audit service for outsourced data in clouds, as well as optimizing for high performance in audit. Its main advantages is this scheme improves the efficiency of verification. It has a high performance, trusted computing attempts, another potential alternative access to achieve the design aspiring of other mechanism.
Let's see the data flow diagram of this project. The first one is Twitter's extraction. This extraction process is exactly related to query issues. It will take out all tweets associated to the target extracted through Twitter dataset. It contains the keywords of the target, sentiment analysis tools, or applied on untrained tweets. It will translate slang words from tweets. These words are usually important for sentiment analysis. It will transfer these slang words into their standard forms by using the slang word dictionary on the internet and then add that word into the tweets. It will also filter out non-English tweets if more than 20% of those words. It will also remove URL from the tweets. The second one is selection of accurate sentiment. After modeling the sentiments, the system selects the accurate sentiment from it. These sentiments automatically select reasons candidates by finding the most relevant tweets for each background topic learned from FPDLA using the messenger. The rank the candidates by assigning each tweet is the foreground tweet set of the one of them or the background. Candidates associated with more tweets are also likely to be to the main reason. Extract sentiment variation point. After assigning the labels of sentiments from all extracted tweets, it will track the sentiment variation using some descriptive statics. In this paper, it is necessary that analyzes the time period during which the overall positive sentiment and the negative sentiment climbs upward while the other negative sentiment climbs downwards. The last one is sentiment estimation. The system has to distinguish proportion estimates from population size estimates because they have largely varied. When the result set of the query is very small, then proportions can be meaningless and non-significant. While for large populations with a small evaluated samples, population size prediction can fall into a very large confidence level.
Only can be decrypted by the private key and vice versa. Decrypts the file in association with the public key PK and the user's private key SK and generates a original message M. If and only if the set of attributes S that is associated with the private key SK satisfies the access policy state that was associated. Let's see the project. Open the cloud and client project. Now, start cloud button. It will show the cloud users. Click listen receive to accept the file request from the user. Now, client has to select a file. It will automatically generate a group key for the files. Copy the group key and enter here. Now,
Click Listen for download button. To receive the request for the key, cloud server has to click the file request button. Client and server has been successfully connected. Now cloud is matching the group keys for the particular folder. Click download now button. Here select file, splitter file button. User has to select a receive path and start the client to get the files from the user. Here choose a file to send to the user. I'm choosing a image file to send to the user. The file has been successfully transferred. Now click details button to know the details from the cloud to the user. Click info button to know the cloud status. Now open the file monitoring source code. Click monitor button. Now choose a cloud storage files. This monitoring will do where there is an action performing for renaming the files or inserted or deleted the files to detector. Now click auditing button. To know the upload audit, click this one. To know the download audit, click this one. It will show the audit list. Now click cloud audit button. How many files are deleted? It will shown here. The renamed files will be shown here. The total number of upload files is 37 and the denied file is 10 and the viewed denied file is this one. It will display in here. The total number of download files is here and the modified file of the cloud and the modified files will be displayed here. From this, the project gets over. Thank you.